Bradley, ya se acabó esa canción. Voy a tener que coger una breve pausa. Me tengo que calmar porque, brother, estoy un poquito excitado y creo que acabo de hacerme una tremenda suciería. Pero eso no...
Come on, baby, come on! Yeah! Yeah! Stupid horse! I'll chop your head off! Who is this dickhead?
Tommy Vercetti. You remember me.
Excuse me. I'm a little anxious. Never trust a goddamn horse. You do a good job. You work for me now.
I work for money.
As I said, amigo, you work for me now.
I work
for... Shut up! Some Judas has betrayed me. He thinks I don't know how much money I should be making. But stealing 3% is as good as stealing 100%. No one does this to me. No one. You follow him from his apartment, and you see where he goes. Later, we will kill him.
This asshole thinks he can mess with me? If this is the best Vice City has to offer, this is gonna be easy.
Fernando, what the hell is wrong with you? Silk shirt, hairy chest, enough aftershave to drown a household pet, but I still cannot get it. I tell them you are an ignorant fool. Without the symbol of power, fertility around your neck, what kind of woman is going to respect you? That is why I have teamed up with Medallion Man, the shop for medallion beauty. You see, sometimes girls like other girls, but they need men. Men with big, bulging, gold-plated discs of virility. Buried in the deep jungle of their hairy chest. Medallion Man caters to all levels of masculinity. For the animal lover, a cobra, a stallion, or gorilla medallion brings out the beast within. For the Civil War enthusiast, how about a medallion that tells the story of the Battle of Bull Run to the Gettysburg Address? And for the traditional man with the raging Oedipus complex, a gold-plated picture of mom to hang around your neck and really impress the ladies. Don't forget, every woman knows if you can support him at...
Slow, Granddad.
You better keep on running, asshole.
Should keep us on the air for another 15 minutes at least.
Thankfully, due to the generosity of the people at DeLeo and Furax, the fascinating show Legal Review will still run. But now, back to the pressing issues.
Actually, before we let you get back to the show, I'd like to say something. I know that public radio may not seem very important in an era of poverty and famine and immense personal greed, but I can assure you it is. And not just because I say so. Look at the facts. 15 of the last 37 American presidents and 47 vice presidents have appeared on VCPR in the last month. 33% of all Nobel Prize winners started out in public radio. Without public radio, we would never have discovered gravity, or the pizza, or the fact that a lot of people love to hear themselves rattle. Anyway, sermon over. I hope you folks at home understand how passionate we are about public radio, and it has nothing to do with the fact I got kicked off the networks.
That was very moving, Jonathan. Back to pressing issues. Where is the creep? Put him on!
Hello. As you may know, you're on VCPR, and this is Maurice Chavez. That is, I am Maurice Chavez. That's Chavez, not Chaves or Chavis. This isn't a game show. Sorry about the upbeat opening. This isn't a game show. It's a political and social debate on free radio, without adverts. And I'm still Maurice Chavez. Hi. Next up on Pressing Issues, we tackle one of the most important issues in our country today. The issue of perception. Not credit card fraud. That's deception. But we're talking about perception. How we perceive the world. These are optimistic times we're living in. A time of go-getters and doers. Our hero is the entrepreneur, the shaker and the maker. Positive thinking, we are told, is everything. Think it, and we can do it. Or can we? Let's press the issue. Now, personally, some days I wake up and I look out the window and I think it's great to be alive. Other days, like payday or my ex-wife's birthday, I want to hide under the pillows and cry. But that's me, a man of contradictions, as my therapist said. He was a Jungian. But whatever. I'm Maurice Chavez, and on our panel right now, we've got three very contrasting views about the issue of positive thinking. On my right, I have gothic artist, vampire hunter, and, in his words, man... You don't sound excited to be here.
No, man. I'm mind-numbingly depressed. It's great.
Okay, I'm going to have to interrupt you there. And on the left, I have positive thinker extraordinaire. A man who dragged himself up from the gutter. Jeremy Robart.
Hey, the ghetto, not the gutter. I didn't live in the gutter. I lived in the ghetto. I'm a survivor, not...